What up, everybody? It's Joe from Complex. We're in New York City at Stadium Goods with the Bodega Boys, Desus and Mero.
What's good?
You already know.
Happy to be back home at Complex.
You know what I'm saying? With the homie Joe, you know what I'm saying?
Joe the Puma with a yoga guy.
Yeah, I mean, I used to run up in homie's office like, yo, fam, I got two pairs of sneakers. Let me hold something.
True story.
You know what I'm saying?
It's true. Let's go.
Let's get it.
Mero, as much as you hated Jordan,
yeah.
I read that the 11s, though, you went crazy for.
Yes.
You asked your dad to get them.
Because I seen them, and it was just like, the design was just like undeniable. Like, to this day, like, this is one of the hottest sneakers like I've ever seen in my entire life. And I saw them, and I was like, yo, I got to get them. So he took me, we jumped in a work van, went all up and down Fordham, all up and down Broadway, St. Nick, everywhere. And it was stores like this when they started to, like, wrap in plastic. Like, yo, don't touch these shits too much. And sold out everywhere, be it to the point that they had signs like, yo, we don't have these no more. Get out of here, like spelled in like Dominican English. Like, we don't have it these, go away. We only have a fila no more.
And then did you get them years later?
I had to. Years later when they re-released them, just had the cop.
Those were dangerous sneakers because this is how you got exposed if you had fake Jordans back in the day. Because if the logo wasn't right, like if Jordan was getting dunked on or something, or we had the wild butt yeeks or whatever, that's how people be like, yo, you had to walk funny at school with
like,
shit. So people gonna look at the logo.
Like, why your jump man got diabetes?
With the Fugazi joint. Your man doing a strong layup. Like, that's not Jordan.
Like, nigga, those are the Antarios. You wildin'.
That's a Bill Paxton shoe. For all black one, I always like the Masters. Cause look, this bitch. Ooh, sweet,
gold
man.
Hints.
This gold hints. You remember they were saying on Twitter that they're called the Masters because low key they were subbing slavery? Which sounds wild, but if you say it in the barbershop, niggas be like, word,
niggas
word,
be like, word,
that.
Word, that's facts,
that.
That's facts, bro.
See the bottom?
I read that.
That's Africa, see?
Yo.
Use your third eye, God.
Yo, open your third, decalcify your pineal gland, God. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Teach these devils.
Think about it, Jordan's a place in the Middle East.
You know what I mean?
Look at that.
Yeah.
So listen.
Open your mind, B.
As the models go on, they start to get a little weird. What do you think about like 16s and 17s?
This is a sneaker that comes with a foreskin. Look at, what is this?
Yeah.
Why do you need all this extra skin on your sneaker?
I was mad happy when these came out because as a Dominican, I own a very strong foreskin. And these came out in like a burgundy, gray, and white colorway at first. And I was like, yo, this cut, if they do a little brown in there, it might match my penis. You know what I'm saying? So I was looking for a sneaker to match my penis, and
I
was there.
You can't even like do any lateral motions. It's like a yacht right there. What is that, fabric? You gotta stop the game and flip it down.
Shit is wild magnetic.
You look at these, and it was like, all right, Jordan had a vision in the beginning. He was like,
yo,
this sneaker, this thing. Around here, he was like, yo, whatever.
Yo.
Just throw something on there,
He's like, yo, make it look like a tuxedo shooting. I don't care.
I was in Australia, make sure that looked like the opera house. I'm going back to sleep.
And what about all these LeBrons now? I know you guys wear the Kith collab.
You got the Kith collab.
Those are hard.
You got these.
Those are
hard. Got the quality joints. You know what? I had to come around on LeBron joints because at first I said they look like robot shoes. And then also the bubble looked like they were going to pop. Those are actually some of the most comfortable shoes I've ever worn.
Ever. Yeah. And they're great for hooping. Be like, actually, like if you actually, like I'm washed. So like I just hoop with my kids like, and I just cross them up.
Yeah.
But like the strap that comes around these joints, like that shit really secures your ankle, bro.
I'm so washed, I put these on before I played 2K19. Like, I'm not playing basketball for real.
We're talking about Nike, obviously the big news, which I wish you guys were on to cover it. Sticking with Colin Kaepernick.
Sticking with Colin Kaepernick.
And then other people.
Taking a knee.
You know what I'm saying? Shut
the guy. I don't feel that in the morning.
You know what I'm saying? I just creased these, goddammit.
What do you think about the cutting of the socks, though, and things like that?
That was, you know what?
That was OD. That was, first of all,
I respect it. Like, I respect it, because you know what? How mad you gotta be to cut your.
All
they
the
weren't
socks.
Even taking their socks off their feet. They were just like cutting it with dull spoons.
Come on, fam. Like, how you cut your socks with a spork, my G, and injure yourself in the process?
Anyone out there saying phone posits are dead, pull up. I will fight you, because I have too many phone posits for them to ever be dead.
That's right. Also,
shout out to everyone in D.C. still wearing phone posits. Go, Mo.
Kill
go, Mo.
Shout out to Wale.
Look at all these phone posits.
Foams is the sneaker equivalent of Tim's. Like, if you see a dude with foams, it's like, yo, this dude got several felonies.
Feel how heavy they are. These are not casual sneakers.
Yeah, nah, those are stomp a dude out sneakers.
All right? There are people in the Bronx that wear these just for job interviews. That lets you know what level of savage we're talking about here.
That's a fact. You can wear those to court.
This match your
coppers.
Baby.
Yeah, the coppers.
This matches your Burberry shirt.
Ooh, you're killing it.
Style.
Also, a little known fact is that these were designed for the Bronx because they are bulletproof.
Oh, you know wow.
What BX Footwear Air Force Ones.
You already know, the official shoe of the Bronx.
When you're born, they give you a pair in the hospital. They give you a lifetime certificate. Every year you get a pair of white Air Force Ones and low black Air Force Ones.
If you're born prematurely in the Bronx, they put you in the warmer with a pair of Air Force One and highs on.
In fact, the warmer is actually a Nike box. They send you home in it. Like, yo.
Straight up.
Do you guys remember trying to get them growing up or what?
It wasn't even trying, like, that was the sneaker you got.
You got them.
Your parents were like, you're getting an Air Force One. Like, they were not it was not a respectable sneaker. It was just like, here's your sneakers.
There's three Bronx shoes. There's the Uptown, there's the Timberland, and then there's the Clark Wallabies for when you gotta get into the club and you need to wear a formal shoe.
Or hard the Skechers. That was their hard
bottom. Or the fake Diesel sneakers. You could also wear those.
Other iterations, the Supreme one. What do you think about?
They were wild with this. This is when the culture, like, come on, Supreme. Y'all didn't even try.
Fam, look.
Somebody was on the trade, saw someone in NBA jeans. It was like, boom.
Dude, we got it.
Boom. We're done. New season. Let's go line up lemons. I like these because, listen, for a little while there, Nike was making bad bitch boots for guys. you can wrap that around your ankle.
SF Air Force Ones.
The SF Air Force Ones for the safari.
You know what I'm saying?
I'm not going anywhere near a safari. I'm going on the train. I look ridiculous.
The four trainers is a safari sometimes, though. You can't front.
You're holding no traffic because you got two straps. Like,
when you're not wearing Tim's, sometimes you're wearing sneakers in Tim's colorways a
lot. I like it. It makes me feel at home. It makes me feel because when you have on a Tim's, you also have on weapons on your feet at any time so you can stomp someone out. And now this is like if a Timberland and Uptown had sex one night, just off went to Don Quixote, had a little too much hookah.
Say a little Henny.
Look at this beauty right here.
When the Henny's in the system.
What do you even call this color? It's like buckwheat or new buck or?
You know what I'm saying? Nah. Yeah, wheat?
Flax.
Flax, look at that. Flax. Wow. Come on, B. Whole Foods with it.
Two times.
You know what I'm saying? These are wild too. This is like some Ghostface Killer shit. He's like, yo, I got the white and cream God. You know what I'm saying? It's like dripping like marble cake God.
If you smoke before you put those on, you're gonna turn. You're like, oh wow.
Oh,
yo, my sneakers got vitiligo. Yo.
What the fuck, yo?
Wow.
Man, that's when they make you wear khakis. If you work at Best Buy and they make you wear khakis, you can rock those.
They be like,
you know what I'm saying?
All right, as long as they're slip resistant.
Yeah, that's fine. Okay. You can wear those.
We have standards here at the Cheesecake Factory.
Another thing synonymous with you guys, Tim's, come on.
Of course, the official shoe of the Bronx, man. Like,
the 9/11 Tim's, you know what I'm saying? Respect the flag joints.
The Jewel Santanas, the Air Jewel Santanas.
And these are these are regular Tim's. They just say A-Life on the side. They're probably like $500 more.
That's it.
Love it. I love the scale.
And only double sole, right?
Double sole.
If
you're single sole, you're undercover cop.
You are undercover cop.
Listen, just give me my ticket and keep it moving.
Keep it moving. Let me tell you something. If I see you in butt nakeds, you know what I'm saying, with a Mark Teixeira jersey, fam.
There's three of y'all standing around the turnstile. The train came in the station, but y'all didn't leave.
I know what you about to do. You about to do this. Stop right there. I saw you fair evading. That's a TOS.
Oh, man. They got the baby blue crypto. Adorable. Baby first. You know what I'm saying? Face slashing.
These are low key hard though. Like if you go full early aughts and throw on like the American flag jacket with the bandana, with the paper towel bandana on and shit.
But now if you were them, people are gonna be confused. They'd be like, you just like the hood or you MAGA? Get out of my country. Like, nah, I don't want that.
You know how you can tell? If you go on a construction site and you see a dude in a pair of those, then you know what time it is. He's like, I wear my flag on my goddamn boots. You got a problem with that? Go back to your fucking country, you piece of shit.
You guys wear a lot of brands. I think there was a stat that you didn't repeat shoes on the show for like 6 months. Is that true?
No, not for 6 months. Forever on the show. Never repeated a pair of sneakers on Desus and Mero, and never repeated a t-shirt on Desus versus Mero.
That's crazy.
Every show we set like these little parameters, people catch on to them. But no, I might have worn a pair of Tim's 2 times in a row, but not the same pair of Tim's. But never, ever, ever. Check every episode. I've never repeated a pair of sneakers on the whole show we did.
That's insane.
That's nuts.
Now, special pair though.
Yes.
$3,700 Pharrell Human Maids.
Wore these on the season finale, series finale of Desus and Mero. A special gift from Wex.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Shout out to the homie.
I didn't get them, but
okay. You know what I'm saying? I saw these, I was like, wow.
Thanks, Wex.
I was like, wow, we doing a lot right there, man. That's what, like every now and then you get a pair of sneakers that's the flex. And like those, like I still have the original box. I still got the original box. The box came in. I still got the UPS thing. I just got them in the corner. I just looked at them like, yo.
You just imagine. Pharrell with like the little sunglasses case, like, here. Just blessing you like with the wild, even tone, like, yo, take these, put them on your feet.
We can't leave without talking about Kanye.
Yeah, of course.
Yeezy season.
What do you guys think about his designs? And, you know, he's been in the news a lot lately.
Well, first off, this is one of the greatest sneakers ever made.
Ever, yeah.
The Red Octobers,
yeah,
these Red October. I'm still sick because I was home when they did the online drop at like 1:36.
Surprise drop, yeah.
And what made it worse, because the next week, the security guard at my local Rite Aid had on a pair while
really?
He was working. I was like, come on, man. So now they're reselling for like $8,000, fam. These were so hard when they first came out. It was the Nike Yeezys. Woo. And I love the Adidas stuff, like the early joints. This is like one of the most comfortable sneakers. This is gonna sound like mad gas, but to fly in, like on a plane, you can clip them on and off for TSA. Okay, that was a flex. I'm sorry.
Yeah, that's a flex.
And then see, Yeezy even got us buying like sneakers that look like they got peed on. Like,
you know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying? He got the thing. These right here, we're going a little, the dad shoes. I like these. I like the Wave Runners. Yeah. Like, I like what's going on here. I like the chunky sneaker that's just in right now. But then, Yeezy, man, like.
He's doing a lot. He's doing a lot with these. Yeah. They. I don't know who came out first, if it was the Balenciagas or these, but they're very similar in design. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's all I'm saying.
And then, sadly, these came out after, you know, his problematic statements, and that's why the resale was lower. But he's keeping his word, because the next pair that are dropping are going to be the most released in production. So he kept his word. So at least Yeezy kept his word about one thing.
Well, talked about everything now. Easy part for you guys. Browse the shelves, see what you're feeling.
It's just cop.
Yeah.
Just cop. Let's go.
It's about to go down. Yeah.
I made the decision. Can I get these in the 10 and a half?
Yeah, 10 and a half sounds good. I got you.
All right, cool. This is like Willy Wonka in a chocolate factory, or now I'm getting confused with the R. Kelly album, which is very problematic. Yo, these right there, so hard. And I need, shout out to the homie Nigel Sylvester. I need these right here, 10 and a half as well. Still looking?
Yeah, man.
In the Bronx, you always wanted these. Please, 10 and a half.
Got you.
We made it.
These shits right here. Super hard. Shout out to Acronym. They always come out with some wild designs. These are definite go.
Hell yeah, these are good. Size 12, right?
Yes, sir.
Sounds good.
Again, banging with Acronym, you know what I'm saying? And the bronze, you know what I'm saying? The South Beach jump offs, you know what I mean? From when I'm in Miami.
All right, so after tax is gonna be $39.89.
Okay, I got a Metro card with like $3 on it. Can I put that towards the balance?
No.
All right, fuck it. Swipe life.
So, Desus and Mero came through, told some hilarious stories. Make sure you check out the Bodega Boys podcast and their show at Madison Square Garden.
You know what I'm saying?
November 11th.
November 11th.
We're restoring greatness to New York. We're bringing back a championship. We'll put us out on the rafters.
11-11, B.
Yo, Joe, let's go get some big yogurt, man.
We're going to tear that shit down like Billy Joel.